Hello and welcome again to the School of Light. And this is Pastor Deb. We have been working in the course entitled Mental Health and the Forever Person. 1 + 1 + 1 = 1, a new math. We are now getting ready to start lesson number 5, the kingdom within and its interconnectedness. What? I am a kingdom? Yes, dear one, you are. And you are a three-part system that is called a kingdom, as we have been learning about in the other lesson. Yes, you are a kingdom. Do you know what that means? You don't? Well, that's okay. This lesson will help you to begin to perceive this new concept about yourself as a kingdom within and understand it. A kingdom is a territory of land, customs, culture, with a ruler, a king, and its subjects. How can you be a kingdom, you ask? Very good question. You're not a kingdom of anything, and you don't have any subjects to rule over, and you don't have any territory or an empire to rule over, you say? Oh, yes, honey, you do. Let me explain how you and your three-part system is a kingdom. And it has a king, a ruler, and it has territory, land that it rules over, and it has subjects and slaves. A kingdom is defined as a land, territory, a domain, where a king has complete rulership through its rights of authority, legal rights, dominion, power, and total management through control. So let me help you to see how your three-part system of physical body, your soul, and its two levels of consciousness, and your forever person are a kingdom, and its king is the soul. The kingdom of you has land, your physical body, and all of its systems of life, and the forever person, and all of its systems of spirit and life. The soul is the king, the ruler of both of these lands, and all of their riches of life, skills, abilities, and they are to serve the soul, the king, as the soul desires. Oh, this was not the original pattern for the three-part system of you, dear one. No, the original pattern of rulership of this kingdom was that the forever person and its heart, its mind of love, joy, and peace of the kingdom it came from, heaven, would be the king of this land, of its soul and its two levels of consciousness, and over the land called the physical body and its systems of physical life. But somehow this pattern was destroyed, and the soul's subconsciousness, the hidden man of the deep heart, became the king of this land, of these three parts of itself. The soul and its needs, its lust of its eyes, what it looked at with its eyes of the physical body, and the lust of its flesh, the desires of pleasure and to avoid pain through its physical body, which became the slave to these desires, and the pride of its life. Its heart became lifted up in pride because it believed it was the king and deserved to be, and that it did not want to be ruled over by its spirit, the forever person. A kingdom with a king, a land of three, a ruler and slaves, a human with its three-part systems of physical body, soul, and its two levels of consciousness, and the forever person. Are you a human? I think you are. So you are a kingdom. Your soul is the king, and your physical body and the forever person are the king's slave. Do you know that a king desires to have a powerful and glorious kingdom? Do you know that glory, wealth, and health of the king is seen and reflected in the glory, wealth, and health of the kingdom and its lands and subjects. A king's reputation is seen by the control of the land and its inhabitants. A king desires for others to see its power and authority, its dominion and glory in the land. So if that is true, what would you see about the kingship of the kingdom of your kingdom's land? If the physical body is sick, diseased, having mental health disorders, is unhealthy, addicted to anything, and not in balance in its systems, what would we say about your kingdom? One of glory or not? What would others say about this king of your land, its kingdom of you? A wise king? A good king, a glorious king? Or would they say that your glory is weakened and not strong, not glorious, not radiant, due to what is being reflected out through the land of your physical body and soul? Of course, most cannot see the spiritual condition of the forever person to even know its condition of either one of darkness or light of this area in the land called the kingdom of you. Yes, your soul is the king of this kingdom of you, of your physical body and its soul and its forever person. The soul is king. It is the ruler, the authority, the one with power and dominion over all the land of you, of your very actions, behaviors, deeds, lusts, your thoughts and ideas, your concepts and principles, your deep hidden parts of the subconsciousness that have been ruling from deep places of hiding. Yes, your soul is the king of this three-part system of physical body, of the two levels of your consciousness and your forever person. So I hope you are beginning to see yourself as a kingdom with a king, and what lands the king of your kingdom rules over and controls. When did this begin in you? In the womb, for humanity had already been changed from its original pattern of the rulership of the forever person as king, and the soul and the physical body as subjects, when the helpmate to the forever person, the soul, took rulership over the forever person in a long-forgotten garden, in an incident of eating from a tree that the forever person was instructed not to eat from, but did at the leading of its helpmate, the soul. The king, the forever person, was toppled from its rulership of this kingdom and fell into the darkness of the dungeons of the rulership of the soul and its lust and desires of its heart. Yes, you and your three-part system is a kingdom, and your soul is the king. The physical body is a slave to the soul, and the forever person is entombed in the darkness of slavery and captivity, and must do the bidding of the soul. Yes, that is the current condition of you and your three-part system, a kingdom with a king, the soul, and with slaves of the physical body and the forever person. And that ends this lesson, number 5, the kingdom within and its connectedness. It has been an honor for you to have listened to another lesson of mental health and the forever person. 1 + 1 + 1 = 1, a new math, here in the School of Light with Pastor Deborah as your teacher. Come back again to lesson number 6 and hear more about yourself and others. Lesson number 6 is entitled, What Does It Mean to Be Healthy? So until the next lesson, this is Pastor Deborah. Love always and forever, Pastor Deborah, a teacher of the School of Light Ministries of Agape Love, Love is Here's Global Teaching Ministry. I'll see you in lesson number 6 on mental health and the forever person. 1 + 1 + 1 = 1, a new math. Until then, love, Pastor Deborah.